So I was cut off in the middle of filming. So welcome to my channel, Vet Dandy Lines. My name is Millie. I was talking about unboxing Kretschik bullet journal. And I was actually talking about she already created in late November and December the second bullet journal, because this was already introduced in the fall of 2019. She created a ochre yellow bullet journal, but with the ginkgo leaves as instead of the green and leaves. So she used I think it was black colored ginkgo leaves, but with the ochre yellow on the hardcover. So I'm gonna open it because it's quite difficult. It's quite tricky. So let's turn it upside down and try to shimmy or I want to go, because it's here is a sticker and I don't want to move the sticker, but now I have to. Okay. So they, I don't need this bullet journal. I'm going to remove that aside. It was just to show you how ginkgo leaves look like. Okay, so I removed this band. What does it say here in the back of the paper? In this journal of Kretschik and Mus, that's the company that makes the books, or in this case, this bullet journal, in collaboration with Kretschik, you can what can you do here? You can make your own agenda, planner, creative diary, or this now a bullet journal, art journal, travel journal. The paper is cream colored and dotted. The binding is flexible. Therefore, the book is easy to stay open, staying open, and in the back you'll find a spot where you can put your loose clippings, pictures, stickers, and keep it and store it there. Even your pen, you can never lose it because of the handy loophole. Pen loop. I'm sorry. Yeah, I have to. So this is the invoice, but it won't say the price. But I know by my heart. I believe this was $12.50. This was $15. So I already received the invoice online in my email. So this is just the paper of delivery that they indeed send it to me. So these two items. So it said it is a soft cover. I've never heard of a soft cover. I like to read books, but I only am known into hardcover and paperback books. But I've never heard of soft cover. This is the first time. So that's why I need to take my time to touch and feel this soft cover. Okay, when you open this, you see, it stays open. Contrary of this one, when I open it, it wouldn't stay open. Then, there's some glued spot here. Oh no, slightly. And there's a glued spot here. I'm gonna try to remove it. Okay, you see, there's a glued spot. So here, there's a little booklet. It says inspiration book. And I can open it completely so I can see better. So this is how it looks like front and back. I'm gonna close it again. Let's see. Wait a minute, I have to charge it. I have to charge it because I don't have enough energy. Okay, I'll open it the first page. So here is a picture of her. So this is how she looks like. This is Kretschik. She is called by her real name, I think, Marin. Marin. And this is her logo. This is how she sign her videos with this logo, Creative Chick. So this is the booklet that she made. She said, "Welcome in my journal. Gladly, I'd like to show you in this little book with many examples and tips, show you how to, what to do with this journal. With love, Creative Chick." Then, it says, "Hey, Creative Chick. Chicky." Oh, she's calling me Creative Chicky. Okay. "Hey, Creative Chicky. Well, you don't mind it says Chicky because she has a following that is not only women, but also men. I mean, I'm not talking about adult men. I'm talking about young men in elementary school. Because there was, in one of her videos, there was a young man. I'm not sure what the age he was. 12 or 14. And he was bullied and laughed at because he kept a bullet journal. And they laughed at him because it's a girl's thing. Well, I'm sorry to tell you, but the first mentioning of bullet journaling was created by a man wanted to organize his calendar or agenda, and he created the bullet journal. So I'm sorry to say that all the people that laughed at the poor little guy, this young boy, that it is a girl's thing. No, it's not a girl's thing. Everyone can join. Everyone is welcome to bullet journal because it creates organization in a chaotic life. So I'm really passionate about discrimination, how there is no need for discrimination in a world of bullet journaling. So I'm sorry, I'm very passionate. So it says, "Hey, Claire Chicky," and she says, "What nice that you have bought this journal to help you along the way, a little bit along the way. I'll explain in this little book what you all can do with this journal, and I will give you some examples." So that's actually this quote is taken off this first explanation. So I don't know why they do that. It's like double. Okay, then she continues. Says she is talking about herself. And let's see, what's this picture? Oh yes, she also likes to draw and paint. And this is some of the spread. This is a spread of her bullet journal. I believe it's called junk journaling, but I'm not sure, because they put art, creative art, that can be drawing with pencils or markers or with paint. And this is from her paint book, and she made this. So these are examples. So even if you're not so good at it, at drawing, like me, I'm not so good at drawing and painting, but I still get some pleasure in having a me time and just play with whatever's in front of me. It can be pencils, colored pencils, or colored markers, or what do you have? Paint, ink, whatever. Just to play with the colors and different kind of papers. There are different kind of papers to use those, they say mediums, but it's actually, I don't like to use the word medium, but they actually are mentioning about pencils, markers, and paint and stuff like that. So, and then they are talking more. This is also one of her drawings that she made in her bullet journal. So this is how she bullet journals. When she's done, This is how she bullet journals. She shows in the videos how she does that in her bullet journal. Because in the beginning, she bought bullet journals from other brands before she had her own bullet journal. So she tested, or she played with her bullet journal, and in this is her style and her way. So she makes videos about it, how she does it step by step. But she also, when she's done filming the videos to put it on YouTube, she also makes a picture of her example or the page that she finished in the bullet journal to put it on Pinterest, because I've already seen some on Pinterest. I also do Pinterest. I mean, I like to see examples on Pinterest. It's not that I have my own Pinterest account. So you get a lot of styles, because she doesn't have one style, because you are creative and you use what you have in your surroundings and what you have bought. So you get a lot of, how do you say it, inspiration? No, examples. I don't know how to say it. But here are a lot of, if you do not follow her on YouTube, or as Crea Chick, you don't watch, she has two channels. One is for these things, the bullet journaling and DIYs, etc., etc. But the other thing is about her personal life when she vlogs. But she doesn't vlog daily. Let's see. So these are, this is the little booklet. So you can go and continue. Then I see these. She also sell these. Oh yes, she also, this is the second item that I'm not interested in. I believe these are washi tapes. And she sell them like this. But I'm not really sure, but I believe these are the washi tapes. Okay, then we open the bullet journal. You get the first page is dotted. And then press on it. It's dotted. See, you can see it stands on its own. Now let's see some more pages. Then you'll see it lies better. It, this one, it won't stay. If you open it and press on it, it won't open in that way. She also mentioned that in her own bullet journal. She said in the other bullet journals that she bought or was gifted to, or if she was sponsored, I'm not sure, but she was gifted to, or she bought it. She said every page is different, she mentioned. And that's why in collaboration with Mas, she said she wants to have some space. And every page is the same. So here, you see, there is a space in here. Every page is the same. It's not like all the other bullet journals that it's off and wonky. So that the dots are so close to the edge, or like this, or like this. All the pages are different. But in her bullet journal, she mentioned all the pages are the same. There is the same space on the side and the bottom and the top. So let's see if I can find. I want to have. Where is it? Yes, this is what I want to show you. So she said also she wants especially to have two ribbons. In this case, she has in her bullet own bullet journal, she has two ribbons, the black one and the white one. She also mentioned that if you go in the back, that you have some kind of envelope where you can put loose stuff, loose paper, stickers, etc., etc., pictures, and so forth. Then you have a pen loop, so you can stick a pen, and it doesn't matter what kind of pen you stick here. That's my oldest son. Hey! You can stick a pen, it doesn't matter what how fat the pen, or the pencil, or the stift, or the marker is. You can still put it inside, and it will stay. It won't leave, it won't go. You have always a pen in your grasp. Then she says, if you bullet journal, every bullet journal, if you use stickers, die cuts, etc., etc., it will fatten up the bullet journal. And that's why she created this elastic. So even if it fattens up, it will still hold together by the elastic. That was what she explained. She also said, I don't have the details. She said in her video, and it's also in the description of Bookspot, that her paper, it has some kind of thickness, and it's not a cheap bullet journal with a thin pages, so that if you use markers, alcohol markers or the other one, watercolor markers, that you will maybe not see the ghosting on the other side of the page, or maybe slightly a little bit of ghosting. And if she said also, when you use watercolors, because then you use water with what kind of medium you have, the watercolor marker or the actually watercolor paint in these little boxes you have, once you wetted it, it's with a cheap paper, it's so wet, it takes a long time to dry. And because it's I'm not saying it has some kind of coating, but because of the thickness of the paper of this this page, it will not be so wet when you put your drawing onto it. But you still need some kind of a dryer. I call it a hair dryer. If you don't have that mechanism or electrical device that looks like a hair dryer or blower, I don't know how to say it. If you don't have that particular thing that every crafters have, I don't even have that. I'm cheap. I just use my blow dryer, my hair blow dryer. So then you can quickly make the water vaporize, or how you say it, you can remove the water on your paper by using the hair blow dryer, or that device that all crafters use, the dryer. So she explains a lot in her video. I do not know which one it is. You have to look it up by yourself, because I will not write it on my beneath my video. If you are interested, look it up. She only speaks in Dutch. I believe in the corner you have an eye or something, and you press next to the eye, and I think there are three dots. I think you press on the dots on your cell phone or your mouse. Click with a mouse on with a laptop. I don't know how you use your computer or desktop, but if you click in the corner of the monitor of your computer, laptop or desktop, then you can choose the language. I believe you can choose for the option English, because she only speaks Dutch in her videos. Is there anything else that I want to say? I still don't know what the English word is for uitgeverij, but here it already says the logo Creachic. Can you see it? It's a scissor, but it's not very good. You cannot see that well. Then you have the MAS logo. So you have two logos. And then where you... This is the www.masboeken.nl. And boeken is a Dutch word for books. And then you can see the other two bullet journals from Creachic. And other books, bullet journals from the MAS stock or collection. What do I want to say? I didn't order. Oh yes, that's what I want to say. I'm also interested in the other bullet journal, the ochre yellow one with the ginkgo leaves on it. But that one is still 19 something euros, almost 20 euros. You can say both books are now, because it's not December anymore, both books are now 20 euros per piece. It doesn't matter if it's this green one with leaves or the other one, ochre yellow with the ginkgo leaves. 20 euro per piece. But I said it was introduced in December or end of November, but it's not hitting the stores yet, the newest, latest one. That will appear somewhere in March. And in Bookspot, they already mentioned the date for the yellow one. The yellow one is on 15 March of this year, 2020. So I think somewhere in that week, maybe before or after that day, particular day, you'll see it in stores and in other online stores. So that's a tip. So I'm also waiting for that day to come, and then I'll order that too. Because I don't know how it will be and how my creation is going to be on this spreadsheet. So I am working with this one and a bullet journal. I don't know if I'm going to use this one or the other ones. And I'm going to show you the other ones. Oh, I forgot. I was charging it. I'm going to show you the other ones. So, it's the floor. I kicked all the things on the floor. So, as you can see, these are, I showed you before in other videos, these are my other bullet journals that are blank, that I haven't touched, that I did not appear. I think these are notebooks. Some are bullet journals, not all. So you see, I have a lot on this space in my cupboard. So I'm gonna put you back here. So, oh wait, I can do it like this. Yeah, I am really happy with my findings on Bookspot, and I hope maybe you're not interested in this bullet journal because you already have your own bullet journal. But I know that in the American market, there is also like the ones from Amy Tangerine, and she's from LA, I think. And there's another one, she's a Canadian, Amanda Rachli. She's also a YouTuber. She has her also her own bullet journal. And there are loads of other bullet journals on the American market. And I know that maybe you live in America, you prefer to use that kind of bullet journal. But here in the Netherlands, I will show you the ones that I'm interested, I want to pay for, and I want to use it. But I just want to store it, because I don't know when I'm gonna use this one. Because I, as you can see in the cupboard, I have a lot of other bullet journals that I also want to use and tackle. But you know, I have two hands, and there's only one year. So like year 2020, and then next year you have 2021, and then so on and so on. So I can only use one bullet journal per time, but I can also do it like Job's Journal. There's another YouTuber, Job. He is Korean, but he lives in Canada. He used different kinds of journals at the same time, but not, for example, four journals that he used. He used it every day because he cannot use all his spare time to work four journals at a time, for example. He just want to do the one he does day by day. He has another one that is a travel journal, and when he go on a travel, and there's another one is the travelers journal. Now the travelers notebook that is originated from Japan. He also used that one too, and there's another one. I think it's a junk journal where he does a drawing. He draws, but not really big stuff. But you know, like bullet journaling, drawing. He likes that, you know, like one page, and that's where he he draws and colors his own style, his design. There are a lot of YouTubers that I follow.